स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ यू ऑल डूइंग टुडे? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर सेफ एंड डूइंग गुड। इन चैप्टर टू वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ऑर्गन्स एंड सेंस ऑर्गन्स। यू नो अबाउट ऑर्गन्स, डू यू रिमेंबर? What are organs? We have many parts in our body. They are called organs. Then we learned about 5 sense organs. We have 5 sense organs. They are sense of sight, sense of touch, sense of hearing, sense of smell, and sense of taste. So 5 sense organs are eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. Okay. Then today we are discussing more about external organs. Organs are mainly divided into 2: external organs and internal organs. Okay. In chapter 2 we already discussed about organs, then 5 sense organs and their functions. About 5 sense organs, we learned the sense of sight, sense of touch, sense of hearing, sense of smell and sense of taste. That is sense of sight eyes, sense of touch skin, sense of hearing ears, sense of smell nose and sense of taste tongue. That we learn. Every human having 5 sense organs. Today we are discussing more about organs. That is, organs are mainly 2. They are external organs and internal organs. External organs means which appear externally. Some organs appear externally, they are called external organs. For example, eyes, ears, nose, tongue, then hands, you know. External organs are broadly divided into 3 parts. They are head, trunk, arms and legs. Head, trunk, arms and legs. As you know, our head has eyes, nose, ears, mouth and hair. And the front portion of our head is called face, that we learned. Organs are mainly divided into 2: external organs and internal organs. Organs are mainly divided into 2: external organs and internal organs. External organs means we can see these organs. They are organs which appear externally. Organs which appear externally are called external organs. For example, eyes, ears, nose, then hands, legs and all. So external organs means some organs appear externally. Some organs appear externally. They are called external organs. External organs, examples also we see here: eyes, ears, nose, hands, mouth, legs, etc. Internal organs. Internal organs means we can't see them. Examples are brain, lungs, kidney, heart, etc. These organs are inside our body. These organs are inside our body. Example, brain, lungs, kidney, heart, etc. Okay. Then, external organs are mainly divided into 3 parts. External organs are mainly divided into 3 parts, that is head, trunk, then legs and arms. Head, trunk and legs and arms. So first one is head. Our head has eyes, then ears, nose, mouth and hair. That we learn. The front portion of our head is called face. Then eyes help us to see the world around us. Nose help us to breathe and smell. Ears help us to hear sounds. Then mouth help us to speak and to eat. Then we have tongue and teeth in our mouth. Tongue help us to know the taste. Then teeth help us to chew the food. Okay. External organs are broadly divided into three parts. External organs are broadly divided into three parts. They are head, trunk, arms and legs. So first one is head, second trunk, third arms and legs. So external organs are broadly divided into three parts. They are head, trunk, arms and legs. So head, you know, this portion is known as the head. We already learned that one, head. And below the neck is known as, below the neck portion is known as the trunk. And you know, arms and legs, that you know. Okay. Head. Our head has eyes, ears, nose, mouth and hair, isn't it? Then the front portion of our head is called face. Then next one is eyes. About eyes, eyes help us to see things around us. Then nose help us to breathe and to smell. Then ears. Ears help us to hear different sounds. Then about mouth. Mouth help us to speak and to eat. We have a tongue and teeth in our mouth. Then tongue help us to what? Tongue help us to know the different taste. And teeth help us to chew food. Okay. We learned that one. In the sense organs, we learned about eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. Then about the hair also we learned. The strands on our head are collectively known as hair. Okay. Then skin. The skin is found all over our body. The upper layer of our body is called the skin. The skin protects our body. We feel various sensations with the help of skin. That means if it is cold or hot, that is the various sensation we feel with the help of skin. Then what? We learn the sense organs also. We learn how many sense organs? 5 sense organs. Then eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. Then, so head complete we learn. Then about the trunk. Trunk means below the neck portion. Neck, you know, the part which connects the head and trunk is called the neck. This part is called the neck. The neck portion means the part which connects the head and the trunk. The part which below the neck. The part which below, the portion that is below the neck is called trunk. Trunk portion means the part below the neck except the legs and arms is called trunk. The part below the neck except legs and arms is called the trunk. See this portion. See, below the neck except legs and arms is called the trunk portion. Okay, and I mark over here, this one is the chest and this one is the abdomen. The upper and heart portion of the trunk is called the chest. The upper and the heart portion of the trunk is called the chest. Here this portion is the chest. The upper and the heart portion of the trunk is called chest. And here the lower portion. The lower and the smooth portion of the trunk is called abdomen. The lower and the smooth portion of the trunk is called abdomen. Then the rear portion of the trunk is called the back. And you know, the rear portion of the trunk is called the back. So we learned the chest, abdomen and back. Okay, arms and legs. We have arms on either side of trunk. We have arms on either side of the trunk. We have arms on either side of trunk. Arms help us to work. Arms help us to work. Okay. Then legs. Legs, they are under the trunk. Legs are under the trunk. Legs help us to walk, jump and run. Legs help us to walk, jump and run. Okay. And here you can see the picture of our palm. And you know the names of your fingers. This finger is thumb finger. Then next one is the index finger. And this one is the middle finger. And this one is the ring finger. And this little finger. See here. It's clear. This one is thumb finger, then index finger, then middle finger, ring finger and little finger. And you know, this portion is our palm. And this one here, this is the wrist. This one is the wrist portion. Okay. Then we have how many fingers? We have 5 fingers to each hand. We have 5 fingers to each hand and 5 toes to each foot. The sharp edged parts of the fingers are called the nails. The sharp edged parts of the fingers are called the nails. Okay. Okay, children. So we learned about organs, sense organs, their functions, then about external organs, then head, trunk, and about arms and legs. So please learn up to this. Thank you.